following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
This is the War Machine Rhino, the last ever ECW World Heavyweight Champion, and you're listening to Damage 365 Radio. Keep listening, or you'll get gored in half.
Esposito's Pizza and Pasta. Check us out at one of our fine locations, 930 Route 34 in Matawan, New Jersey, or 233 East Main Street in Manasquan, New Jersey. From pizza and salads to pasta and buffalo wings, we have something to suit every member of your family. Whether you're seeking to take out, delivery, or you just want to dine in, let us do the dishes, as we would be more than happy to take care of your next meal. Our courteous and friendly restaurant staff is here to meet and exceed all your expectations. We promise an enjoyable experience each and every time we serve you. Try our award-winning Sesame Crust Pizza, our recent winner at the Las Vegas Pizza Open. Visit us online at sesameseedpizza.com for store hours, menus, and phone numbers to one of our great locations. Esposito's Pizza and Pasta, so close to eating at mom's, but without all the yelling.
Hey, this is Bruce Pritchard, and you are listening to Damage 365 Radio. But I need you to know something. Just because I love you doesn't mean I like you.
Hey, wrestling promoters and booking agents. You know where you can get inexpensive prints of your hired talent? Right here at Fast Copy Printing Center, located in the Pearl of the Bayshore. That's right, whether you need 8x10s, 11x14s, posters, long format, or even weatherproof signs, we can do it all. We also can create promotional items for your business, such as pens, business cards, drink koozies, banners, or just a coffee mug. Stop on down to Fast Copy Printing Center, 81 Broad Street in Keyport, New Jersey, or call us at 732-739-4646. No job is too big and satisfaction is guaranteed. Tell them Damage 365 sent you.
This is Lanny Poffo, formerly the genius full of glory and renown. You are listening to Damage 365 Radio.
The Funkenstein Wrestling Superstore, selling wrestling memorabilia from all around the world, including WWE, Impact, ROH, Japan, Mexico, and the Indies. They sell action figures, lucha masks, t-shirts, trading cards, magazines, DVDs, autographs, collectibles, vintage video games, and more. Stop in to get tickets for local independent wrestling such as UWA Elite, CZW, and Synergy Wrestling. Located indoors at the world-famous Englishtown Flea Market, Blue Building, Booths 45 through 48, 90 Wilson Avenue in Manalapan Township, New Jersey. Open every Saturday and Sunday from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. all year round. Visit them at Facebook at facebook.com/Funkenstein Inc. New Jersey's largest wrestling store is the Funkenstein Wrestling Superstore. Tell them Damage 365 sent ya.
Attention, attention everyone. This is Allie, and you're listening to Damage 365 Radio.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
Hey, this is the National Treasure, Nick Aldis, and you're listening to the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast.
It's the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. With the Enforcer.
I believe you're called Enforcers, Gordon.
I sell women's shoes.
And the Stallion.
Stallion, baby!
I am not what you would call a handsome man.
I'll kick you in the nuts and you'll smile at me and like it.
All night long.
Welcome back to another edition of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. My name is the... Wait, I messed that up. No, All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. We are your hosts. You're the Stallion. I'm the Enforcer. And we are back with yet another edition of the show. Last week, we were joined by AEW Dark and Independent Talent, Life Coach, and streamer, Vert Vixen. That was a really cool show. And just so everybody knows, she was talking about her podcast. Her video blog has dropped. Go check it out on her Instagram and Twitter over at Vert Vixen. But we're going to ask a favor of you guys. Here's what we need. $300. No, I'm just kidding. What we need is to go to iTunes, wherever you go get your podcast. Most people watch the show. I don't blame you. Stallion's a great looking guy. Some spank bank stuff. Whatever you decide you want to do. But what we need is you guys to head over to the podcast app, iTunes. I don't know how that works on the internet. It's S, Steve Jobs. Search All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. Give us a rate, a review, a subscribe. Throw a couple of R's in there for us, a couple of stars. I'll even take 3 stars. Do I want 5? Do I want Okada Omega? Sure. Will I settle for like a Goto Yoshihashi? I'll take it, man. I'll take 3 stars, but give us a review. It'll help us, and maybe we can finally make some money and I won't be broke.
Yeah, I think that would be ideal if people are able to do that. I don't think that Apple Podcasts or iTunes allows you to break the 5-star scale, such as Okada and Omega did a few years ago. But you can go and give us a 5-star rating and a review if you enjoy the show. We appreciate that. And subscribe would be fantastic as well.
Yeah, even if you don't enjoy the show and you listen to it, you're like, he's a fucking idiot and his takes are terrible. That's when I'll take the 3-star. I don't need the 5. Give me a 4. 3. You can go half star, quarter star, 4.78, whatever you want to do. Just rate, review, subscribe, like, all that stuff. We would really appreciate it. But more importantly, this week, big pay-per-view, WrestleMania. No. Oh, yeah, that's over. WrestleMania week is over, and we are heading into the summer. But the way we're going to get there is possibly the biggest co-promotion match in recent memory. Impact Wrestling this week, Sunday night, is Rebellion. Impact World Champ Rich Swann takes on AEW World Champ Kenny Omega in a title versus title match. A month or so ago, we had Impact Wrestling Women's Champion, Knockouts Champion, sorry, Deonna Purrazzo on the show. And Deonna Purrazzo was saying there are a lot of opportunities for men to do the crossover and the Forbidden Door, and what she wants is the women to kick open that Forbidden Door. So maybe we'll see a little bit of that this weekend, because Deonna Purrazzo will be defending her title against the artist formerly known as Emma, like Prince Iaukea, right? We're just gonna go with that. Tennille Dashwood. And there are a lot of good matches on the show available on pay-per-view Impact Plus, who Joe and I, a little behind the scenes thing, are new subscribers of the Impact Plus. So I know you've been going back. You're watching a lot of Abyss matches, a lot of brother run stuff, right? That was like your favorite era.
Yeah, actually, that is my favorite era. A lot of the Triple X, Sports Entertainment Extreme, if you like, Vince Russo, things of that nature.
The Voodoo Kin Mafia shirt, right?
You still have love that Voodoo Kin Mafia. Yeah, big fan of the Voodoo Kin Mafia. There's a lot of good stuff out there in the archives of Impact and formerly TNA Wrestling. So actually, the good news is, I believe, I don't know the exact dollar amount, so I probably should have come prepared with that. However, if you purchase Impact Rebellion or any other Impact pay-per-view on Fight TV, you get a discount for the first few months on Impact Plus. So even more reason to go ahead and purchase Impact Rebellion this Sunday night on pay-per-view on Fight TV. As you mentioned, it is Impact Rebellion on April 25th, 2021. So it will be, as you mentioned, the main event, Rich Swann and Kenny Omega. But we are here to go through all of the matches. There are 8 matches on the card, and of course that will be the main event. So I am ready when you are, my friend, and I guess just quickly for anyone listening to this show, I don't want to misrepresent anything. So I do not have access and I do not have the ability to watch Impact on a weekly basis. So please take these predictions knowing that, because it is not, I do not have a lot of background knowledge on the week-to-week storylines other than reading recaps and things of that nature. So I just want people to know that going in.
Yeah, I also have the same issue, and it's not for lack of trying. It's because of our fucking cable company. If you're a Long Islander, you understand. You hate Dolan. You hate Optimum. You hate Altus. Fuck them. Fuck them all. But because of them, I can watch Impact week to week. Luckily, you go to Impact Wrestling on YouTube. They're updating stuff there all the time. So we're doing the best we can. But in the meantime, fuck Cablevision.
The funny part is they also provide our internet, so I could see that cutting out in the middle of this at any point in time. But you know what? So even more reason to go ahead and get started. So here we go. 8 matches on the card. Let's start out with the recently revived Knockouts Tag Team Championship. It is the team of Fire and Flava, Kiara Hogan and Tasha Steelz versus Jordynne Grace and TBD.
Yeah, see, this is tough. Fire and Flava have been really, really strong tag team. Tasha Steelz, she's really... I've seen Kiara Hogan a lot. We saw her in Shine and Evolve. And Tasha Steelz, I wasn't very familiar with until she was in Ring of Honor and had a couple matches in NWA. They've been a great tag team. I just don't know who in God's name Jordynne Grace's partner would be. For me, I'm going to go with Fire and Flava because I don't think they should be losing yet, but I don't know who Jordynne Grace's partner is. So what do you got for me, Joe?
I agree with you. I think that they should leave the titles where they are. Now, again, having not watched Impact on a regular basis, I did hear that Taylor Wilde is supposed to be returning to Impact. So I don't know if she's in play to be a partner here or not, or if she's doing something different. I probably should look that up. I do know that Jazz recently retired on Impact, so it will not be her. So
Deanna, the virtuosa.
That's right. Virtuosa. So it could be, I don't know if it could be Taylor Wilde. I'm sure if anybody listens to this, they'll tell me that why it can't be, or it could be somebody completely different. There's a lot of opportunity out there, a lot of great women's wrestlers across the country and all over the world to fill that spot. So I'm interested to see who that will be. Next up, we have an 8-man tag team match. We have Chris Sabin, Eddie Edwards, James Storm, and Willie Mack versus Violent by Design, which is Eric Young, Diener, Joe Doering, and Rhino.
You know, here's the thing. Love EY, like Joe Doering. I don't know a lot about him. I know he's a big in Japan guy. But to me, Eddie Edwards has been like the heart and soul of Impact Wrestling for the last, what'd you say, like 5 years, Joe? 6 years? Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I would say that's probably relatively fair. I know he started with, you know, teaming with Davey Richards in the Wolves, and then he branched out onto his own into a singles career, and he's won the Impact Championship a couple of times.
So I gotta go with Chris Sabin, Eddie Edwards, James Storm, and Willie Mack. Those are the guys that kind of the company is. Chris Sabin's been there forever. Eddie Edwards is the current and the future. James Storm's is like the heart of the company, and Willie Mack is really taken a liking to by the fans there. So I'm gonna go with the good guys here.
I'll take Violent by Design only because I think that putting over the heel group would be good, and I know this recently came together. I think not too long ago, so I think that's the way to do it. I mean, these guys, as you mentioned, Sabin, Edwards, Storm, Willie Mack. A lot of them have been with Impact or have history with Impact for a while. So I don't know. I'll just go with Bound by Design here, and just to be a little bit different. Next, we have a last man standing match between Trey Miguel and Sami Callihan. I'm going to go ahead on this one first. I think, you know, I don't really know what the deal is with Sami Callihan. I think, you know, he's been in a lot of high-profile matches, but I also feel like he loses a lot. So, in my opinion, I'm going to say Trey Miguel gets the win here. I think he's someone that stuck around after the Rascals left and went to NXT. So, I'm going to go with Trey Miguel to get the win.
I think that's fair. I think Trey Miguel is kind of he's I don't want to say he's a young kid. I don't know how old he is, but he's been kind of lights out for Impact Wrestling, and I feel like he's a guy that could definitely build around. So I'm going to go Trey Miguel as well.
There you go. Next, we have a singles match. So former partners in the WWE, Matt Cardona, formerly known as Zack Ryder, and Brian Myers, formerly known as Curt Hawkins. These guys both came up in our local area of Long Island here, and they have a singles match coming here on Sunday. I've seen a little bit of the backstory on this. I don't really know. I guess if it was me, I would have Matt Cardona go over. I think he's a little bit bigger of a name. You know, Brian Myers is a very good wrestler, I think, but his role was probably just to get good matches out of people, or at least that's what I think it should be. So I'm going to go with Matt Cardona to be the winner here.
Yeah, I'm with you on that one. He's like the guy they would call a good hand, if you will, Myers. So I'm going to go with Matt Cardona here too, because I think he had a weird stint in AEW where he came in, he helped out Cody for a couple of weeks. He did like a couple of dark shows and that was it. The way AEW works, it sounds like, is when they bring in the new talent, it's a couple of week deal. And if you get over, you get over. And if you don't, you don't. He was mid-pandemic, so I don't know how that really works. But I also think Cardona is kind of more of a name, more of a title-worthy guy here. And unless they're going to have a longer feud, I think you give Cardona the win and move him up the card.
All right, next up, we have a three-way match for the Impact X Division Championship. It is the champion Ace Austin with Madman Fulton defending against Josh Alexander and TJP.
Okay, I got a fucking bone to pick with everything here. Josh Alexander is not in the X Division. The guy's like 235, shredded with 4% body fat. There's no way Josh Alexander can fit in the X Division.
I mean, no limits, bro. No limits, X Division. That's all I know.
Well, Zach is Austin Aries and the whole thing. I don't know. I don't like him being in this match. I'm a huge mark for the Ace Austin. Love the double A, if you will. I think he should definitely retain here. Big Ace Austin guy. TJP, by the way, doing great stuff over in New Japan Strong. He's kind of all over the world, but let's let Ace Austin run with it. He's got a great gimmick, too.
I agree. I think Ace Austin is a strong character. He's a good wrestler, and I think he should be a big part of the show going forward. I would believe that he should keep the X Division Championship here in this match. So let's go with Ace Austin there. Next, we have a singles match for the Impact Knockouts Championship. As you mentioned earlier, the friend of the podcast, Deonna Purrazzo,
is FOTP.
Defending against Tennille Dashwood, formerly known as Emma. And she has Caleb with a K in her corner. Corner also with a K.
That's so Caleb with a K is such a good gimmick. Deonna Purrazzo has really stepped up her game, not just because she's a friend of the podcast. That's not the only reason. She's really stepped up her game to a whole new level, and I just heard her again on Busted Open recently, and she was saying how like a year ago she was part of these cuts that the WWF just made, and she was like, I don't know where I'm going to go. She goes to Impact, she fucking rules the roost, and she's now the standard bearer of the Knockouts division. So no reason here Deonna should not get the W in a good but dominating fashion. And then call out Hikaru Shida, man. Hikaru Shida, Britt Baker. Deonna Purrazzo also just mentioned she was asked who she would like to see join Impact in 90 days. And she mentioned Billy Kay, Peyton Royce, Mickey James, and her BFFFFL, Chelsea Green. So the Impact Knockouts division is just really firing on all cylinders here.
Yeah, I agree. And I think those are all great possibilities and opportunities of matches that can happen. And I think the fact that, so I think to that end, keeping the title on Deonna Purrazzo as the top wrestler in the division right now for Impact is the right thing to do. So I'm going to predict that she wins, and maybe we'll get some of those new opponents coming in the next couple of months. Next, we have the tag team championships on the line. It is Finn Juice of David Finlay and Juice Robinson from New Japan Pro Wrestling going up against the good brothers of Doc Gallows and Carl Anderson, former Impact champion.
Dude, can I just say something here about Finn Juice? Can I go?
It's your podcast, buddy. That's what we're here to share opinions.
If I could just say something here for a second, Joe. I was watching, you know, all the collective stuff, WrestleMania Week, IWTV. There were thousands of matches. I think it was Southern Underground Pro. I believe that was a promotion. Fucking Finn Juice pops up. Finn Juice, main event. In a brewery, in front of like, I don't know, maybe 100 people. And they had a banger with Kevin Koo and Dom Guarini, Violence is Forever. And I was like, holy shit. Like, I liked Finn Juice, but now I'm like a Finn, whatever is one of their fans, right? Like, one of the marks for those guys. They fucking rule. So I think Impact put the tag titles on them to pop a rating. And they're probably going to go right back to the Good Brothers. So my prediction here is going to be the Good Brothers with the whole Kenny Omega fuckery. But Finn Juice fucking rules, man. Big Finn Juice guy now.
I had the exact same thought as you did on the title change. I think they brought in some guys from New Japan. These guys, I'm assuming, live and work in the, you know, in the United States, or originally are from the United States. So maybe that's possibly why they're here. I don't know. But I do think it's a short-term title reign for them. And I think putting the titles back on the Good Brothers is probably the direction they're going to go. Especially, like you said, with everything happening in AEW with the Good Brothers and Kenny Omega being part of the new expanded Elite faction. So I'm also going to go with the Good Brothers. And that brings us to the main event, as you mentioned earlier. It is title for title. It is Kenny Omega as the AEW World Champion against Rich Swann, the Impact World Champion. Both titles are on the line, so the winner will walk away with two championships.
Here's the thing, right? Like, I'm looking at this two ways. And the first way, Joe, is there any way in the holiest of hell you could see Rich Swann carrying the AEW World Heavyweight title?
Not really, no. And I think part of that, there's a lot of reasons. The biggest part of it for me is that, and a couple people have noted this in reviews and recaps that I read on Dynamite from yesterday, is that they barely mentioned at all the fact that this match is happening on Sunday. Or at least they could have mentioned it a lot more and made a bigger deal out of it. So I don't know if that's intentional or not, if there's something maybe brewing underneath the scenes here. But, I mean, to have Rich Swann come and take that title that AEW has worked the last couple of years to really establish as a meaningful championship, you know, with significant title reigns and guys that the audience is familiar with, to have it go to Rich Swann, who has never been on Dynamite, and I don't know how much of a crossover audience there is for Impact, so I think that would be not the direction to go. So I don't really have any doubts that at the end of the night, Kenny Omega is going to still be the AEW World Champion, and I imagine that he will then win the Impact World Championship as well.
Let me run an idea by you. Tell me what you're right. Rich Swann versus Kenny Omega Sunday night. In walks Moxley and Kingston. They cause Swan to beat Kenny Omega. They have an immediate rematch on Wednesday at Dynamite. Kenny beats him handedly. What do you think?
Again, I don't. The only reason I don't like that is because Swan has not been introduced to the Dynamite audience. Now, if they had run an angle where Rich Swann appeared on Dynamite and attacked Omega, or even cut a promo on Omega on Dynamite, I could see that happening, because at least people that watch Dynamite could have been like, oh, there's this match happening on Sunday, I'm going to watch it. And even if you don't get a chance to watch it, and you find out, like you said, the scenario that you just mentioned plays out, and Rich Swann becomes the AEW World Champion, when you see him on the show the following week and they do a rematch, you could at least be like, oh, I know who this guy is. They had that match at Rebellion, and he's the Impact World Champion. You can get some eyes on the products, both products that way. But they didn't do that. So that's the only reason I don't like that scenario. Otherwise, if the AEW audience was more familiar with Rich Swann, then I would be fine with that. But I would not like to see them do that in this instance, just because a lot of people would not know who Rich Swann is if he showed up as AEW World Champion.
The crossover people would think, oh, that's a 205 Live guy, right? That's who Rich Swann is if you're not too familiar. No disrespect to Rich Swann, but if you're not an Impact Wrestling fan, that's what happened. There's no two ways about it, really. I think Kenny Omega wins. I think it would be a mistake if he didn't win. Do you think that AEW views Impact kind of like they viewed the AAA title, like when he wrestled Laredo Kid? It's like, all right, man, go do your thing. I know it's your title. You're doing this probably as a favor to Don Callis so they can get the rub more than anything, right?
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's what I anticipated from the beginning, was that this was all kind of a crossover thing built around Don Callis's relationship with, you know, his job and Impact, and then his relationship with Omega. You know, of course, he's a very good TV character as well. So having him on television, I think, is a benefit to everybody. But as of late, I don't know what AEW is doing to try, other than sending Omega there for this match, right? They previously they had sent like Private Party, and Matt Hardy was there, and there's other stuff that was maybe going on. So I don't really know what, you know, the end result of this is all going to be. You know, I mean, if Kenny Omega wins on Sunday, like we're both predicting, now you have a world champion. Now, is he going to go and work some Impact tapings now as their champion? Periodically, you think he would almost have to. If he shows up on AEW Dynamite with the Impact title, that's probably something, right? Where people could say, oh, okay, well, he's going to go wrestle on this show as well. I want to go see Kenny wrestle. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe they'll do some sort of storylines where Impact guys can maybe come onto Dynamite and try to take the title off of him, or do something that way. I think that would be beneficial for a crossover, especially now that Impact is on Thursday nights. So it's on the night after Dynamite, right? Previously it was on Tuesdays. So it was the night before, and maybe something would happen on Dynamite. You have to wait 6 days to get there to see Impact. Now it's the next night. So I don't know what their taping schedule is like, but if you're able to do something on a Dynamite and then tape something for the following night for Impact, then, you know, there's opportunity there to do something and continue to draw out maybe a crossover audience. So I'll be interested to see, you know, what the buys look like for the pay-per-view, especially with it being headlined by Omega and a title for title match, which you don't see very often in professional wrestling these days. So I mean, maybe it'll end up leading to something, but right now I think Impact needs to get some more out of this deal.
I kind of think AEW needs to get some more out of the deal, because the AEW is giving up a lot to not get too much from Impact. But the Finjuice thing, there's a lot of moving parts, and a lot of it's still very confusing. That being said, to your point, I'm going to tune in and I'm going to watch the match, because it's like, it's a big deal no matter who wins. They become a double champion. It's wrestling. Fucking wrap it up. Can I just show you a tweet that Mickey James just posted? I don't know if, did you see this?
Probably not, but yes, you can, of course you can share it.
She said, dear at Vince McMahon, I'm not sure if you're aware, I did receive my WWE care package today. Thank you, always blessed and grateful. And this is how they shipped her stuff.
What is that, a garbage bag? Is that what
that's a cute garbage bag inside of a box that says Mickey on it? That's fucking brutal, dude. That is brutal. That's poor. You know what? Nikki James Aldis and Nick Aldis are going to be just fine after this. And that's our cue, everybody. We appreciate you checking out another edition of the All Night Long Wrestling Cop. I can't even fucking talk. All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. Rate, review, subscribe, iTunes, everywhere you go, at All Night Long WP and all of your social media. And make sure to check out the show and Twitter on Sunday night, as I'll be live tweeting Impact Wrestling Rebellion. That's it for another episode. We are tapping out.